Okay, so here's one of my favourite plants called black nightshade. That's the common name. Maori name's called poroporo. Now there's two plants called poroporo. That's the this one here, the black nightshade, and there's another one called the woolly nightshade. And I think by memory, the woolly nightshade is also called Australian, well, the berries on it are called Australian apple, but I can't remember exactly. But this one here is one of my favourites because it's such a good food source. Okay, it is related to the deadly nightshade, but and there are parts on here that are poisonous, so you must be careful. I normally use the leaves in the boil up, and you use it exactly the same as cabbage or puha or watercress. Cook it for half an hour. You can eat the leaves all year round, and let's just zoom in here so you can get a good picture of the leaves. So there's a picture of the leaves there. Okay, so these veins are, they've always got a dark green sort of a leaf with the black veins there, and in the middle it's always sort of a little bit whitish, and sometimes you'll find the young berries, as you can see, all the flower and then berries coming up there from the middle. Okay, we'll try and come over here to the flower so you can get an idea of the flower. Come out a bit. There we go. Okay, so the flower is sort of, it's got the yellow inside and then the five white petals on the outside. And you can see the flower buds, okay, over here. And then, of course, these turn into green berries, and some green berries over here. All right, just see the green berries here. And these green berries are poisonous, so you don't want to eat those. And also, these green berries turn black when the plant's more in season. Okay, and the berries were, I've eaten the berries before, they're not bad, but apparently in the old days they were used in to make jam by the early settlers. Okay, now this plant here, the good thing about this plant is it grows all around the country, and it actually grows around the world. So survival situation, if you're on operations overseas or anything like that, you find yourself overseas in a survival situation, you know, you can find it and use it to eat and boil it up, okay, or eat the blackberries. I normally take these yellow flowers, the yellow and white flowers off. I normally take them off when I'm cooking because they're just a little bit bitter. But we'll go around and have a look in, at some of these specimens. There's some beautiful specimens around here. Okay, so here's a young one. Okay, just a couple of young ones there. All right. And here's a beautiful mature sort of a specimen. Okay, really, really nice. We'll zoom in there a bit to the leaves. Okay, the leaves are sort of like almost like a spade, shaped like a spade. And you can get some decent sized leaves. You can see my hand here. Okay, that's the size of the leaf. So it's a decent size, some decent sized leaves. They can get bigger than that. And so what you do is we just cut it off at the base. Of the actual stem itself. I'll show you the stem actually over here. Okay, here's the stems here. that they can be like a dark green to a dark purple color, okay, and they can also just be straight green. All right, here's another big leaf over here. Okay, now there's two ways of collecting this poroporo. The first way is by just plucking the leaves off. You can just pluck the leaves and just leave the stem in place, which is what I do sometimes when the plants are a little bit scraggly. Or you can cut the whole plant and take it all as one. And sometimes I'll do that, take them home, you know, just throw them in a plastic bag, take them home, and then from there I'll pull all the leaves off. So you don't want to really be cooking the stems, okay? The stems are a little bit they're too tough, okay? You just want to be cooking up the leaves, all right? But there's heaps around here if you can find them, okay? And you pick enough and you can get a decent feed out of it. There's a nice young one there, okay? So what I'll do is when I get the chance, I'll get a bunch of this and I'll cook it up and in a boil up. What does it taste like? It's hard to say. Puha is stronger than watercress, okay? And poroporo has a stronger taste than, I'll rephrase that. Puha has a stronger taste than watercress, and poroporo has a stronger taste than puha, okay? But it's still nice, okay? It's still nice. If you like puha, you'll really like poroporo. The main thing with these things here is that you've really got to make sure that it hasn't been sprayed, okay? So when you collect this stuff, you've got to make sure that there hasn't been any spraying in the area, okay, where people have been spraying putting spray on the weeds, because for some people these are weeds, okay? And so they'll poison them to try and kill them off, all right, because they don't realize that they're such a good food source. But anyway, hope you've learned something, and we'll leave it at that. Okay, cheers, bye. Okay, so I thought I'll quickly go through how to collect this poroporo. So what you do is you just grab it, go to the bottom, near the bottom, and just get your knife, okay, and just cut the base off, like so, okay? And like so, all right, just cut it off. And then what you want to do is throw that into a plastic bag, okay? And go to the next one. All right, now these here, these stems, they're only really soft. When they're really soft like this, they'll just break, okay? They just like break quite easy. All right, see that? Break real easy. When they're old, they're like really hard and, well, not that, yeah, they're sort of like real rubbery, okay? All right, so all we want to do is cut it off like so, and we collect it like that. Bring this in a bit closer. Okay, and I normally grab it all like this, okay, like that. and I slap it into a plastic bag, okay? And when I get home, I pluck all the leaves off, okay? Throw the stems out, and throw the flowers out, and any berries, I throw those out as well, get rid of them, okay? And the leaves I cook up, all right? So that's how you collect the poroporo. And actually, just while I'm looking here, there's a nice little puha just down there. I'll just see if I can zoom in on it. There it is there. Okay, just a tiny little puha, just a baby. All right, try and get in there. Looks like a Sontris olorosus or something, but puha, but we'll do that another day. But poroporo, that's how you collect it, okay? And good kai, all right, cheers. Okay, so the next thing we do is, as I said, I just went and got a plastic bag. We get the poroporo and we put it into a plastic bag, okay? Stem down, all right, into the plastic bag, and we collect it like so, okay? So there it is there, all right? And we just keep going along like that until we fill our plastic bag up. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to collect a few of these now, and I'll think about whether I throw a boil up on, a small boil up, just to show you guys how to cook this up tonight, okay? All right, cheers. So welcome back. I'm just at home now with a few of the leaves, and I'm going to show you how to basically pick the leaves. So what we do is just grab the leaf, pull it off, and we can throw that into there, okay? Any of these leaves, okay? We want to pull the flowers off, okay? Throw them to the side. Okay, grab the next leaf, throw it in. So anything with like the flowers on, or you don't have to go too hard out. You can just pick them. Okay, pick the flowers. Pick the leaves off. Okay, pick the leaves. Alright. So you can do this out there, out in the field, okay? Or you can do it at home. It's completely up to you what you decide to do. Sometimes I do it out in the field, sometimes I do it at home. Just depends if you've got the time and where to do it. Okay, so things like that there, okay, that's all good. It's got a few little flowers there, but that's nothing major, okay. That's fine, just throw it straight in. See, the stem here is only very, very light. It's that's fine, you can cook that. You just don't really want to be cooking big stems like this, okay? In fact, these stems on these ones here are actually very good. You could almost get away with it, okay? But it's nicer if it's just like that, okay? And throw the stems over there. Alright, pluck. Alright, so we're gonna, you want to muck around with it, just go straight into it. Alright, it's all good. And look at what we got here. That's all good. You don't want to muck around, just straight into it. Yep, just pull those things off. Anything like that, buff it. Otherwise you'd be here all day. Alright, anything you can just pull off. That's what you want, just like that. You can pull off separate leaves, like that, boom, just pull it off, throw it over there. Okay, flower buds, pull them off. Yeah, pull that off. It's okay if it tears the leaf, it's not a problem. It's all going to be boiled down anyway. Okay, yeah. Big leaves. Okay, anything, any leaves that are sort of just starting to get a little bit short, okay, buff them. Alright. So anything that looks a little bit sort of suspect to you, that you're not happy with, then just throw it out. Okay, so here we're taking these flowers off here. Alright. It's just about being picky. Because once we start cooking it, the enjoyment comes from being picky. You see that? Don't really need that. Anything you're not sure about, just buff. Right, we're only doing a few leaves here, but tomorrow I'm going to get a whole lot, get the rest of the leaves, and do a boil up, and I'll show you that as well. Okay, so you can pull all these ones here off. That's all good. Alright, we get down to here, take the flowers off, okay, and right here, just, see you got the stem here, just pull it off at the top, lift the stem. The more stem that we can keep out, and just keeping, we just want the leaves, basically, as many of the leaf as possible, or leaves as possible, so we just pluck it out, okay, even if we're just taking slight part of the stem off. The stems make it just, I don't know, it's harder for them to boil down, so it doesn't make it as enjoyable to eat. You know what I mean? You want it nice and soft when you go to eat it. All right. Now this puha, correction, poroporo, is, in my opinion, it's a delicacy. And the reason being is that you can only get it in season. I mean, it grows all year round, but there's only certain times of the year that it really flourishes. And you'll know when it's flourishing when you'll see it. You'll see heaps of it, okay? And that's when you want to grab it. And finding good quality stuff is something you just got to keep your eyes open for, you know. I have actually seen this being sold in the Otara flea market under the name Puha. So I'm guessing that rather than, you know, most people understand what Puha is. So they were selling it under the name Puha to probably try and get it to sell it. Whereas the correct name for this is poroporo. And if you have a look at one of my other videos called Jerusalem Cherry, this plant here is also related to the Jerusalem Cherry, which is it's a very poisonous plant as well. Just the same as deadly nightshade. Some people confuse this with deadly nightshade. They call it deadly nightshade, and it's related to deadly nightshade, but it's nowhere near as deadly. Okay, nowhere near. Alright. Nine times out of ten, if you do eat the green berries, they are poisonous, but you're more really just going to get an upset stomach, okay? It's not really going to kill you, alright? So I wouldn't advise eating the green berries. Blackberries are fine. They're sort of a black-purple, they're more sort of a blackberry. Okay, if I get the chance at some stage when I see them, I didn't see any out there today, the blackberries are, they're sort of not too far away, I'll try and get I'll get some video footage of the blackberries so you can see what they're like. It's basically the green ones that I've shown you already, and they just turned black. Okay, see that one there? Yuck. Alright, throw it out. Alright. When you go through, you can actually go through to see that. There's a good one there. I've accidentally biffed it in there. Alright. Throw it in there. Alright, good leaf. Good leaf. Okay. Good leaf. Okay. Yeah, so these plants, the scientific name is they're of the Solanum family, okay, Solanum, which is actually the same family as, these are related to the tomato plant as well. So the tomato plant, you don't eat the green berries of the tomato plant because they're poisonous, okay. But you can eat the ripe red fruit, you know, of the tomato plant. But, and it's the same as these. You can't eat the green, but you can eat the blackberries. Whereas with deadly nightshade, you don't want to touch any part of that. That'll just kill you. Okay, and same with Jerusalem cherry. Don't even want to go there with it. Okay, so what have we got? All right, you can actually go through and just, you know, when you've got all your leaves. All right, so from here you can actually, I'll just move that camera in a bit closer. All right, so there's all the crap there, okay? And you just biff that out into the garden, not a problem, okay? With the leaves, okay, what we do is you can, if you want to, just give them a bit of a rinse off. I mean, they're clean as anyway. These ones are like clean as, okay? But if you want to, give them a bit of a rinse, you know, just to make sure there's no bugs or anything like that. Especially if you're collecting around housing areas, like around suburban areas and things like that, you never know if there's been like dogs or cats or anything peeing on stuff, okay? There's nothing wrong with just giving it a bit of a rinse off, okay? Sometimes I'll rinse them off just once, it depends, and other times I might rinse it off three or four times. It's really up to you, alright? So basically just give it a rinse off. Make sure you're getting any like bugs and anything else off out of it. Change your water. Alright, throw them in again. Okay, so we'll show you a bit of a better close-up shot here. Alright. So this is. Alright. Alright. So you just give it a bit of a, you know, bit of a clean. You don't want to be squeezing the leaves. Don't bruise them, you know. That's no good. If you do want to take some of the flavour out, like if they're too strong for you, if you're not used to the flavour, because like I said, they are stronger. It is a stronger flavour than puha. So if you don't want it too strong, then you could probably squeeze them and just break them up and take a bit more of the strength out of the flavour. But I like the strength in it. I like it nice and strong. Okay, so the next thing we do is what I'm going to do with these ones here, these leaves here. Okay, what I'm going to do with these here now is I'm actually going to throw them into a little pot. I'm just going to throw them into a little pot. Put them in a pot. And these ones here, I'm going to do what we call blanching. Okay? Because these are the only ones I've got tonight. I'll pick up the rest of them tomorrow night. And Turn on my oven. All right. Okay, so what I'm doing now is I'm going to blanch what we call blanch. Okay, so blanching is basically we want to boil the leaves. Okay, and we can boil them for. Most people say boil them for about 5-10 minutes. I'll actually boil them until they actually soak down, until they soak right into the water. And basically you're cooking it, let it drain out and then cool down a bit and then bag it. Okay, put it in a plastic bag, shopping bag, tie it up and biff it in the freezer. And what that will do is that you can keep it saved in the freezer for as long as you want. So that as soon as you feel like you want to boil up, you just pull those bags out, throw a bit of water on them, and open them up, and then just throw the leaves, the blanched leaves, straight into your boiler. Okay, so that's how you do it. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to blanch these, and as soon as they've boiled down a bit. What I'll do is we'll come back to it. Alright, I'll see you shortly. Okay, so here it's been blanching now for about, I'd say about 6 minutes. Okay, good to have a lid on it. Okay, and you can see here how the leaves have gone like a dark green. Okay, and they've actually boiled down into the water. So that was just straight cold water. About 6 minutes, okay? That's how you want it, looking sort of like spinach, okay? Alright, that's another thing I like to have in the boil-ups too, is spinach, okay? If I can't find anything else, spinach is always good too. So, that's the leaves boiled down, that's them pretty much blanched, that's where you want it, okay? You don't have to go any further than that, alright? So, the next thing we want to do is we want to drain this water out, okay? So, where are we? All right, so let's bring this here over. All right, and where are we? All right, so here you can see I've got a drainer here. All right, it's got some holes in the bottom. Okay, and you want to just like tip it into there. Alright, you can tip, you can actually tip this other water out first if you want, not a problem. Alright, get rid of it. Oh, I don't want to lose the green stuff. Okay, so put it into there. Alright, tip it straight in. Don't waste any of it. Okay, cool. So we've tipped it all out. Okay, we can pour some cold water over it. It's not a problem. All right, just speed up the process. All right, we're just trying to cool it down now. All goods. Okay, so that's draining through. Alright. And so you can see from how much we started with, okay, compared to how much we currently have. Now, this has only been boiled down for, as I said, about six minutes or so, 6.5, maybe 7 minutes max, okay, with a lid on it. And yeah, when we boil it down for about half an hour, 45 minutes in the boil up, that's going to even go softer, okay, and nice and soft, a lot softer than what it already is, okay. But it's already starting to look good, all right. So the next step that we do for blanching is we throw it into our trusty plastic bag from New World. Okay, doesn't matter which plastic bag you use. All right, and we just simply drop it in. Okay, so this is the key. If you you don't have to do all this, okay. Obviously, those leaves could go straight into the boil up, straight into the pot. But as I said, I'm just doing an example for now, and I'll probably get some more. I'll get some more leaves tomorrow night. I'll blanch them the same as what I'm doing now, and then probably on the weekend I think I'll do the boil up, where I can sit back and really enjoy it in front of a good movie. Okay, so we've got our bag here. All we want to do is just do a little loop in it. You don't have to make it tight, okay, because you want to be able to, it's going to go into the freezer. Okay, so just like that's fine. Alright, you've done a little loop in it. And this can go straight into the freezer now, and it'll freeze, and then when we have the boil up, we pull it out. Okay, so normally I do about 2, maybe 3 bags of this up. Okay, depending on how much people are having over for a boil up or whatnot, and yeah, we go for it. So next step is we plonk it in the freezer. Alright. Yeah. Might help if I open the freezer from the right side, eh? Alright. Okay. So chuck it into the freezer. Alright. And Bob's your uncle. So what I'll do is from here, we'll let that defrost. I'll grab some more, as I said. I'll blanch it all, and then on the weekend, I'll slap a boil up together. Maybe brisket or pork bones or just whatever. And I'll show you how it is, and I'll yeah. Okay, cheers for coming along. Okay,
so I've gone out tonight, and I've got some couple of bags of poroporo. Okay, so as you can see, all right, you can fit quite a bit into each bag. All right, so what I'm going to do is I'm going to tip that out now, so you can see the quantity that you can fit into one of these bags. All right. All so that's one bag there. And that's the second bag there. All right, so you can see that you want to get quite a bit for the boil up, especially in my household. People just love the greens, all right, and I'll just move this around a bit, okay. All right, so there's the underside of the leaf. There's the upper side of the leaf. All right, but okay. So what I'm going to do now is I'm going to start to pick all these leaves off one leaf at a time, okay, and sort through it and give it a couple of washes. Okay, and then I'm going to come back as it's blanching. All right, so I'll catch up with you shortly. Okay, so welcome back. So all the picking's been done, and we've got the green leaves here, the ones that have been picked off. So they've all been picked off individually, okay, and you can see from the amount of what we first started with, how much is in here, alright, and all the bits of scraps, okay, all the old crappy stuff is all in here, so that's going to get biffed out into the garden, okay. If you've got a decent sized garden or backyard, a lot of those berries and seeds and stuff like that will actually help to grow more of the poroporo for you, okay. All right, so just throw a bit of water in, as I've shown you earlier, and what we do is just pull it out, okay, like so. All right, just gonna, you can pull that out a bit, like. All right. And this is just basically to make sure that we're just giving it a little bit of a clean. Alright, it's every leaf has been inspected anyway, as it's been plucked off the plant. But this just helps to assure that we're making sure that we're getting any. I don't want all this to be. Probably just shake this out a bit more. Water going everywhere. Okay, so this is just helps, as I said, to get all the insects, any insects in that off, any bits of grass or any little bits of things that we've have gotten through, and also as a backup for any sprays, okay, weed killers and stuff like that, that people may have sprayed. And it's because you don't, unless it's in your own backyard that you're picking the stuff from, you just won't know exactly where, you know, what's happened, you know, been happening with the plant or the plants. All right, so the water's actually not that dirty on here, all right, which is a good sign. But there's no harm running it through twice. Okay, so you can do this as many times as you like, and you can be, you know, as detailed as you like, right? I don't muck around with it too much, as long as you're giving it a decent sort of a clean, you know, you don't have to go overboard. Okay, so with this stuff here, and the stuff that I blanched last night, there should be a decent amount for the boiler. Okay, we'll throw it into, start throwing it into the pot. We'll turn the top of the stove on. Well, I might have needed a bit of a bigger pot. I'll just push it in. Okay, this will all boil down anyway. Alright, it's just a matter of trying to fit it in. I do have a larger pot, but this was the first pot that I seen, so I grabbed it. Always say don't waste anything, all right? Put every leaf that you can in. All right. Okay, so what we're going to do is we're going to throw it onto the oven here. Oh, correction, the stove. Now, right, let that start to boil down. Okay. And what we'll do is we'll come back to this shortly. Alright, so we'll let this boil down a bit and we'll come back to it. Okay, and I'll show you where it's up to. Alright. So I'll see you shortly in about, I'd say between 5 and 10 minutes.
Okay.
So, welcome back. We're coming up to the, about the 9-minute mark now. Okay. And I've had the lid on, but it hasn't really been able to fit right on top. It's sort of been a bit too high. But as you can see, some of these top leaves are starting to be able to get down now. So we want to try and take some of these bottom leaves, okay, and try and turn them a bit, okay, and get some of these leaves that are on the top, give them a chance to get under the water. I want to try and get them under, okay. All right. I'm going to try and spin that over. Just try and spin it over. All right. Just be very careful because this is obviously very, very hot water. It's boiling hot, eh? Boiling hot water. And you seriously don't want to be burning yourself. That's not what this is all about. Okay, so that's starting to look good now. Starting to look like spinach almost. We're sitting on about the 10 minute mark now, but it's a pretty big pot. And this has started from cold water, okay? I reckon give that a couple more minutes, you know? Just let that boil. This is on high, by the way. I'll try and bring this in a little bit closer. Starting to look really nice. How does it smell? Delicious. Just like that, it smells really, really nice, even without the rest of the boil up. Really careful because it's on high, eh? Okay, and as you can see, this is from two bags, okay? Those two big full bags that I had, and it's managed to boil down into this size of a pot, which is a decent sized pot, you know, just for the greens. Alright, well, I reckon that should just about do it. Okay, alright, let's turn that off, and what we'll do is we will move this over to our drainer. Okay, so let's bring this out a bit. Let's zoom in. Check that out. Alright, bring it back out. Okay. I'm gonna grab this. careful. Okay. Bring this back in over here. Okay. And what we're going to do is we're going to drain this into here, just like we did for that little bit the other night. Again, just be very careful, okay? Especially with the steam. Alright. We don't want to lose all this into the sink. Let's just pull all this out. Don't waste nothing, alright? Get every leaf. Every little bit counts. All that luck. Okay. Awesome. Okay. Good stuff. Okay, now we want to cool this down. Cool it down. Cool it down. Okay. Okay. What we want to do now is, when that's cooled down, throw it into the bag. Still a little bit, some parts are still a little bit warm, not so bad. It's better to do this because it's going to go into a freezing cold freezer, and so you want to sort of get the temperature about sort of right, you know. You don't want to put it in straight into the freezer when it's like piping hot, okay. Thank you. Okay, get the last bits on there. Alright. Okay, all good. Alright, so the next thing we want to do, alright, is simply get that. Okay. Get our two handles. Alright. Fill a loop. Take the air out. Take the air out. Alright. And just do another really light loop. Okay. Don't do it tight. Okay, because you're going to undo it. Right, and so that there, okay, is the next bag for the freezer. Alright. So that's where we are. Okay. And what do we do? Same as before. Okay. We open the freezer from the right side this time. Okay, and we place it into the freezer. Okay. Alright, so this is the one we did last night, okay, and that's nice and frozen, alright, and we'll just plonk that in with the other one here, alright. Okay, that should be a decent amount of poroporo for the weekend, and this weekend I'll do a ball up this weekend. And I'll do the last part there for us. Alright, thanks for coming along, and we'll catch you up on the weekend. Cheers.